Hello YouTube, welcome. This now, officially, I've been trying there, but they cut me off. So that's how it is. I try official to see the guys, show guys about this monster. Make sure here, you know, this guy can do a lot, not everything. Having him, you need to have. These guys here, we call them amplifier, and connected with the speakers there. Those ones to have a nice surround music. Then you can hear that the track you mix, how clear is it and everything. So that's how it is. And I really love to share my videos with people because I like YouTube, because they give us tips and tricks so that we can also have ours and produce to the public, and it's free of charge. That is very cool. We really appreciate that. It's very hard to address a lot of people, but you can try. That's the way I do. Yeah, people have been sitting on the system, coming on the system to look for the tricks and trips for each and everybody. People, when they do it on the gaming or some stuff, you know, because you can get bored, you know. So, yeah, that makes us get inspired, you know, because you never get bored. And the way you get it is the way you have to pay back. So we pay back us also with the free things like this. Yeah, music device. So this is a knockoff of Pioneer DJ, the DJ S1. So it's a mixer which came out around to 2016 or 2017, something like that. I bought this one. My first one was Numac. So Numac was a little bit smaller. Yeah, it was beginner. Then I decided that I want something bigger, and then I choose this one. This one I bought it around 1,000 euro. Yeah, it's a little bit two arms and two legs, but it's worth it because that thing is more than disco. It can get down everywhere. It's user friendly, and it's also easy to carry, take away. It's called you can put in your backpack, and you can take it everywhere. And if you have your amplifier and everything, it's going on the board. So I really recommend this because, yeah, those years I had it, it never gets stuck, and I've took it too many places with me. Rain, yeah, sun, cold, and it still survive. Even some of these knobs, they get broken, but it's still on. Like this one we do have, but this one, yeah, but it's still on. Why? Because Pioneer is durable stuff. So before all, let's get into the details. So this is a jog wheel, and this is the buttons for playing pause, and this is the tempo BPM matcher. If I show you now nicely, like this, you see, and this is cue. You can cue your music through here, and you do have needle search, and you can set this wave to go across or any kind you like. You can do it about that with that on the system here. If you go to setup on the screen, so if you bought this mixer, you need to you should get CD with it. It's kind of a just disc. You upload it on any computer. After that, it has a program which is called Serato, and that's it there on that computer. That Serato is kind of a plugin that uses control this controller to store your playlist, and yeah, store your tracks. You can record your tracks and put them in there, cue them, You can even auto record. You can do a lot of stuff with that Serato thing. And that one you can also update it within a few years. I already updated mine 3-4 times. So yeah, every device, even this one, you have to update it too. Because if you never update it, then you can play it with it, and then you just get stuck on the way, which is not good for your audience. Yeah. And with DJ, it's nice if you have clear song from the iTunes and clean songs, clean music. You can record via this one on the USB, but you need to be good because some music, they won't be clear. So you need to adjust this here and the bass too or something. But if you have this is 350, 500 now on the shop, euros. So that is it. And with this one, you can do a lot. So, for example, I didn't finish to show you the details yet because I was into the DJ stuff at what? Music. So this is this one here. From here, this is channel 1, channel 2, A, B, track A, deck B. And this is the master volume. Up, down, this one. This one, we have some knobs of faders or something. This one is effect. We have deck A effect and deck B as well here. And this is for the aux. If you have an aux or something, you can plug it through here. And this is master out, but you can use it with here, like that. Easy as well. And this is the BPM, master tempo. This one you can put, for example, like that. It's on and adjusting. That's how you adjust with this one. That's be a match. See? And this is slip law. This if you want to stretch. Do you touch that on? Stretch. That's needle search. I'm using it now. See? Volume up a bit. Then you can feel. Hi. Sorry for the trembling. My hands. We need a good camera. As long as it's a zero fan, you understand, and do it practically. Slip roll off. And this is synchronized. If you press this and this together with this, music will match themselves. You don't have to do anything in this one and this one. Leveling. Yeah. So this is as well, this is a cue. If you want to cue in, you just do like this. That's your cue in. And extender, if you see that one, deck B, that's extender. See that green? That's extender. That's what I mean. Extend your track. And to take it out, you just press this one like that. It's out twice. And then you stop it. For example, you want to engage a track now. From here, you go on there. Here up, we have jog wheel, and you have some few buttons here. Back, and you do have this one for files, and you do have for deck B, deck A, and this one for files too. So if you want to engage a track here, you go on the jog wheel, you turn it front on the back. For example, I want to engage that on here. Then I press this one. Then after pressing it, you see it's already loaded. But I have to check the BPM on this one like that. because beat them up there is 28. And this one too, check it out. The 70. I need to find the BPM that can match with this one. So I got a little bit up. Okay, let's take that one. Okay, engage it to deck B. So I'd like to mix, but not now. First we go on the details. Now we do have effect one, effect two. But you can adjust this effect one to, we can engage them on both decks, only effect one. And as well, you can engage effect two on this same deck, both of them. And you can effect this effect for this one, and this one for this one, and this one, you know, like that, vice versa. And this button here is for record. You can play your music here, and you can record, press this one, the mixer will record itself to the library, so you don't have to do a lot of it. Yeah, that's how it is. And this is fader. This one, these buttons, is fader start. If you click on like this, they are on now, and then you do, that's on. See? It's fader start. Fader start. Easy and simple. Right? And this is the headphone jack level. So if you want to hear music with the jack, headphone jack harder with the track mix, is this one. But this one, you want to only hear yourself, you just your headphone over here. I do have the jack here for the headphones. Here too as well. You can use both if you're two DJs. Yeah. So these buttons is key. You want to cue your music, for example. I cued this here. See? I cued it already. This one I didn't cue yet. For example, I want to cue this. I use the needle set now here and I play it. Let's hear. No. That's not so good. Have to find a track which is, yeah, this one. Let me check. Right now, let's find a. This one, that one. Okay, now I want to cue it, for example. Now I want to cue it, I cue it there. Okay. The meaning of cue, if you can find a block that you like or something, and then you take one of these numbers, you pick it, and then you press just like that, like this one. You see the number peak to start at that point. So that's a key. And you want to take it off, you press this shift and that. It's off. Again, shift and it's off. That's how it is. And this one is V. This is make your track a little slower, and you can slow it in, break down, and turn up on this. Goes like this. Thus, I make it now break down slowly in a spin. See? That's it. Wake up. But that one, you can do the drop mix, because drop mix, you need to start and stop both tracks at the same time. So if you press like that, put this jog wheel up, then you failed already. It can't work. It's good with a beat mix. So we go now to the effect. This is effect one. To engage an effect is simple. You just press knob like this, because once it's on, it's already an effect. The one phaser. For example, this one there. I play this track. Now I want to engage an effect. I make the beat faster. It's on. It's adjuster. This is the level. If you want it harder, softer, use that. See? And just stop. And you can use it as well as this side. Okay, hear it? This side. That's why I said all effects can use both sides. See? Choose a track you like, you engage it, pop. When you engage your track, first thing you watch, look, is your BPM, where it is, 28. Okay, you find this track again like this, you search any track here, where are you, you want something nice for the audience. Yeah, let's cracking Garrix here. Cool. Yeah, cracking a blade. It's sleepy. Okay. Now, come on. Time's up. Okay, let's go. Yeah, that one. Cool. Which one is that? BPM 31. So I'll bring it this one up to 31. This one means the song is cute. You can't start your music like that until you're professional. So now you use your needle search like this, turn it back to the start. Okay. Now, for example, now you want to mix your music. Okay, you click play. See, I waited the first block and then I press play. When I press play, it go itself. When I have headphone, and then I can level with the jog wheel. I can time the jog wheel front or on the back if it's not level. But this song I choose, they are level because the BPM and they are all same track, same environment. House. Like that. So you make sure this is in the middle. And then you hit that block. And then you put this up a little bit. First, this one has to be down. This is called beat mix. You put it up, when another one is coming, and then you have to switch this at the bottom time. Like that. And then you pull this one down. See that? That's mixing. But I mix my design. Everybody has. You can mix the track on the first, and you can mix the track on the last. It depends with your design and technique. Yeah, technique, people, they need to dance and get happy, you know, if you want to be on the map. So you see? For example, if I have to bring this track back, just pull it up, and this the bass, and then I pull it down. See? Now if you want sleep mode, just press here like this and turn up. Now I want to kill faster. And then I press like that and I go. I go slowly, slowly. See, and I put it on. See? That is basic mixing. But mixing, you need to know your devices and the function very well. And your tracks has to be clear. And playing, you see that this light, it doesn't have to be orange, it has to be green, because then it produces the nice sound. It doesn't have to be like that. That's how it is with mixing. See? And you can mix over here if you have a big speaker and amplifier without this controller, only with this this one. Yeah. So that's a quick one. And if you have a house or something, you just put this on like that. And it's easy to go. You know? Yeah, that's DJ. It's really, really not easy. You need to go out there to talk to people. Get their ideas. Maybe you can bump on the headhunter or something, and yeah, you can have some, get invited, and people wanted to see what you want to do, and yeah, if you've been in the running with it, and then you show your thing, and then you already have it. Yeah, and I try to share this with you. It's not like I didn't want to be a big DJ or something, but DJ is my hobby. I like music, and I like music because it's nice. And I like to share with people about this stuff, because some people, they have stuff, but it's really difficult to operate this kind of device because it will have a lot of knobs and everything. Even this one, I give you only a quart. It can do a lot of stuff. Yeah, so next time I see you in the video part 2, how to mix and drop mix, and how to do some scratch, and how to loop, sleep, roll, and we're going to look about the reverse, and we're going to look about the jack phone, and jack, and the master out, and aux. Yeah, and we're going to pull it with this Remix Station 1000. This one also, I'm going to show you the in and out of it. So, if you're there, yeah. So be ready for the next video for this one, Pioneer DJS 1000. This one I bought 1000 euros, and I had it now for 5 years. So I know the in and out of it. It's not a difficult stuff. So welcome guys, and see you later for another video.